Hey, good morning. Good afternoon.
What are we doing? Just
years ago. This was years ago, bro. Years ago.
If we're not tapped in on the free one, if you're here, you get it. I mean, you get it. They know what's up. Yo.
What? I might have not been hitting my years ago drops properly on the last thing. Damn.
Did you not hit it right? What happened?
My bad. All right, keep going.
Yo, you heard that shit with Nicki?
Years ago. Years ago, bro. Years ago.
Sife, so this yeah, we should do this for Patreon.
This is exactly what I've been talking about.
Well, what are you? Okay, you're referring to the Nicki Latto voicemail?
Yeah. It was not a voicemail. I had a conversation.
Sorry, you're right. Not a conversation.
Okay.
There's a Nicki Minaj Latto conversation.
What was it? Well, how did it start?
Latto said something that Nicki felt a way about, like.
Do you know what she said?
Like something like that, basically, over the last 10 years, there was only one woman. Like, there was, like, for some reason, the way it sounded like the way Nicki took it was like she was saying, like, Nicki didn't allow her to. Allow anyone else to thrive. That's how I took it.
Nicki didn't allow anyone else to thrive. Okay.
Like that was implied in something Latto said.
Right.
And then this came out.
I've done nothing to you. Crazy, yeah, you are. Something that is clearly delusional. It's delusional to say that other girls are flourishing. It's delusional to say that other girls are flourishing. Recognize we weren't giving the platforms that we're being given right now. And I give you props all the time in every other interview for opening the door for that to be a possibility now.
So, in conclusion, what do you think you wanna say about? Let's let you finish your statement about what female rappers were doing before and what they're doing now. I want you to finish it.
I finished it, Nicki.
Okay.
For a long time it was you.
It was me.
Yes. So,
you didn't do your research.
That feeling, that exhale,
that sigh. Oh,
yo, Sife, I gotta tell you, I'm gonna
that
say
that sigh is real.
I'm gonna say this right now on one app on Patreon because I'm confident that no one who could actually expose anything we say on here would get it out. And I don't care that much, but like I wouldn't want to do it intentionally to get attention. That sigh was the exact feeling that I had when I had to sit there in that 1 hour interview where she just fucking undressed me.
Yo, we should put that on 1app. Is that on video?
What? Yeah, it's out. That's on YouTube. What, yeah, re-release it?
Yeah, re-release it.
Yo, I had
to. My incident with her is not on tape, which I wish it was.
So I had to sit there and listen to this person tell me I wasn't talented, I wasn't funny, I wasn't smart, imply that the things I said to her, that I said about her music came from some place of either privilege, racism, sexism. Mm-hmm. I had to sit there and eat crow to this woman's face for a fucking hour.
Yeah.
All these years later, she comes back and is like, yo, that song was shit. That song was trash.
Yeah.
And at no point thinks, man, maybe I should like say sorry to the dude who I literally tried to destroy over something that I now agree he was right.
And you agreed with it back then. You knew what was up. That's why you didn't want to perform it.
Right. Exactly. So when Latto hit that, I was like, yes.
No, Latto is obviously a fan.
Obviously.
Obviously a fan of Nicki Minaj. And I don't know what she said, but you know, I don't know the ins and outs and the subliminal games or whatever these rappers nowadays. But definitely a fit and like being, it's like if Q-Tip called up, it was like, how the fuck do you think you could do comedy? Huh? Why the fuck? How? What audacity do you have?
No. It would be more like that exact same thing you're saying, but Q-Tip would be calling being like, I heard the show.
Yeah.
Exactly. Where you guys said that Busta is the best from a 90s group.
Yeah.
Like, I don't exist. I mean, we never said that, but you get the idea. Like, it's, well, yeah, but we worship you. We literally talk about you like you're God all the time. Like, what do you, like, you could tell. I've interviewed Latto. She spoke about Nicki in an endearing, deferential way. Like, and she was, yo, bro, that was, I had a good, I went, wow, people are really going to see people, maybe if people feel like opening their eyes. But the bottom line is, this is what we talked about a few weeks ago on the podcast. Everyone has their group that's obsessed with them. So the Barbs will never not feel Nicki's right. They'll always reinforce whatever thing she's feeling.
There's some that probably have. There's probably ex-Barbs out there.
You think people, even there are people who've deflected?
You know how people leave the Mormon church?
Yeah.
There's definitely ex-Barbs for sure. But the thing about her, my main problem with her, and I hate, because I did an interview recently. I was on this podcast called Eating While Broke. Very interesting.
You do a lot of. You do so many podcasts. I mean, it's so cool.
Because it's free content. You do someone else's podcast, and then you get 5-6 clips out of it. I know, clip man.
Okay. Okay. But yeah, it's funny because you make time for all those podcasts, but if you and I are booked together, you have to cancel it. Oh, it's really weird how that works out.
Bro, listen.
I'm a conspiracy theorist.
I've told you many times, bro.
What? What'd you say?
Let's go, bro. But you got to be in bed by 10 o'clock.
Oh, really? When were you doing these podcasts? At midnight?
You got to be in bed by 10 o'clock.
You're doing these podcasts at what, 3 a.m.?
I do these podcasts when you're on fucking ESPN.
Well, that's that. See, now we're being truthful.
That's when I do them. You think I plan them at that time on purpose?
Well, listen, no one knows if Michael K is going to re-sign his next deal, so I might be available very soon.
Anyway, this I was on there, and she was like, I don't know, one of the questions was like, who don't you like or whatever. I said, I like everybody. The one thing that comes to mind is when Nicki Minaj talked absolutely crazy to me. And I said, I don't want to sit here and talk bad about a black woman. It's not something I want to do, but like, she is the epitome to me of the people you see going up is the people you see coming down. She is literally why I try to be kind to everyone. Because when people
retell the story of what happened again
I can't because I'm about to put it out. So just hold on.
What do you mean you're about to put it out?
I'm about to put it out. So
you didn't already put it out?
No, I'm about to put it out. Put it out. Put it out.
Why don't you put it out on one app?
It's gonna be on one app, but it's gonna be its own thing.
Okay.
So
we should have talked about timing this story. It makes sense. This is the moment.
I didn't have it ready. I didn't know she was going to spaz out again. But my whole point is like.
But didn't you tell the story on one app before?
I'm sure I have.
I think you have too. I know it's about her yelling at you in front of people.
I'm sure I have, yeah. But the thing is, when a lot of times when you mention her name in the industry to people who work venues or people in the industry or whatever, you mention her name, they roll their eyes and they all have a story.
Oh, yeah.
How much money it costs to get her to come somewhere with the glam, which, you know, whatever. You can't knock it. That's artists have glam. No, not even male artists have glam, too. What am I talking about? It's not maybe not as much, but hair and makeup is a big deal. You got to fly out all these people. But it's not even that. It's the way that she treats people. And when you're hot, yes, you get away with it all. But when you're not and you need that little extra push of something, nobody wants to give it when you treat them like that. Now, then that takes me to my emotions, and I get angry that she screamed on me.
So let's stay there, since you're not going to tell us a story today, but you are going to do it on One App in the near future, maybe next week.
Yeah.
How about this?
Yeah.
What emotions do you feel? Let's go deep. What emotions do you feel when you
think about Patreon? Whatever. I went to go squash the Rosenberg beef.
And where did you go to squash it? The stadium?
She was going to do an interview at Flex on Flex's show at the 25th Street location.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
So she was going to go do an interview. I told Flex, can I come up there? I really need to talk to her. She has an issue with mostly him, but I'm in that somehow.
And
morning show.
Do you recall if this is pre or post Summer Jam?
It's post.
It was post, though. Okay.
Post, of course.
Got it. Okay. It was
but
when
remember,
she
remember the Summer Jam before that?
Yeah, she thought we had problems. Yes.
She came. She approached us on stage. She's like, yo, y'all don't fuck with me. Like, she got in our face.
Yes.
Like, Onika Queens got in our Queens. Onika was in our face talking like trash to us.
Yes. I remember that well.
And I'm like, yo, I know your manager. We love you. We talk about you all the time. We think you're one of the illest lyricists, not female lyricists. Lyricists. She's like, nah, fuck y'all. Y'all be talking mad shit about me. We're like, what is happening right now?
And we're like, people are telling you things that don't actually even hear
this.
We're
looking at each other like, Nicki, what are you talking about? At first, we thought it was a joke.
Yeah, that's right. We thought she was laughing.
We were laughing because we're like, what are you talking about? We love you. And then we're like, oh, this chick is serious.
Yep.
So boom, boom, all that whole year goes by. Summer Jam happens. She has that in her mind. You say the Starship shit. Summer Jam, blah, 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 whatever. So she's talking shit about the morning show. So I go, as I always do, squash beef in on a phone call or in your face. Check my name out in this industry. It's clean.
Yep.
Anyone who's ever had drama with me is be like, yo, Cipha came and spoke to me.
So?
We've settled it. So I go up to T-Flex. I go, Flex, can I come up there? He's like, yeah, of course. Like, of course. Not even, why even ask me? Just come up. So I'm up there waiting. She walks in. She sees me instantly. She goes, yeah, it had to be post. Yeah, it was before you spoke to her. So she sees me and she goes, Flex, what the fuck is he doing here? Flex starts laughing. He's like, Nicki, chill. He wants to talk to you. Bro, she didn't even say hello.
Right.
What the fuck is he doing here?
Yeah. Okay.
Flex laughs. Yo, chill. Like, again, it's so outlandish. Flex thinks it's a joke. Now, I know it's not because now we're already in the shits with her.
Right.
But Flex is laughing like, chill, Nicki, chill. Nah, fuck that. What is he doing here? So Flex is like, oh, she's being serious. He wants to talk to you. Nah, I ain't talking to him. He gotta go or I go.
Oh.
So Flex. So now my mentor apprentice relationship kicks in. I don't want to fuck up Flex's interview and his ratings and all that shit. So all right, let me, you know, all right. She's like, he go, I go. So I go, all right, I'll leave. She puts up five fingers and she goes, 5, 4, 3. So now I have to scurry. So she doesn't leave.
Wow.
And I walk past her and she goes, bitch ass. And I was like, oh shit. So only like whoever was right behind her, which is probably like a security, heard that. So now like security's like tense because Nicki's screaming at somebody and then cursing at him, you know what I mean?
Oh my Lord.
So then I go by, she had a new manager at the time, not the one we knew from the previous Summer Jam, who I knew this manager very well.
Okay.
He didn't hear what happened. He just saw that I was running out of the room like a bitch. He's like, what happened? I go, yo, your girl just fucking threatened me. She just screamed, not me, threatened Flex, screamed on me. He's like, what? What the fuck is going on? Anyway, whatever. So then the time she comes up to talk to you and Ebro was on a weekend. I wasn't around.
Yeah, it was July 4th weekend.
Pre-recorded it or whatever. Mm-hmm. So then y'all squashed the beef. And somehow mine is still lingering.
At least to you.
I heard little things here and there.
Okay.
Whatever. Anyway, what was my point?
We were trying to get to the emotions you feel.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So I felt... So, okay, yes. Yeah. So I feel embarrassed. I feel like a little hatred, like a bit of anger coming out where someone just like purposely plays you. And then that's my.
I never remember that she said the bitch ass N word part.
Oh yeah,
walked by,
whispered it like.
That's
I run this shit. I'm so hot. Flex is gonna kick his man out, And you know what? Flex might have not kicked me out, but I didn't want that to.
You didn't even want to have him make a choice, right?
I asked him if I could come up and talk to her. He said yes. I'll step out. So that's my initial reaction: hatred. Fuck this bitch. Da 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 da. Then I go into my therapy mode.
Here we go.
She's fucked up. She needs help. She is like a troubled, traumatized human being, which we all are.
That's that part.
In one way or another. Some more, you know, extreme than the other. But all of us have trauma. That's a thing. Trauma's a thing.
You're on. Yes. You hear yourself talking? Nick's listening.
I heard
to
myself
you.
Talking. Yeah.
Hey, Nick.
No.
So.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
So I want to. I wish I could help her. You know what I mean?
Oh,
I wish
well,
I could help
you
her.
Can't, and she would tell you to go fuck yourself for thinking that she needs it.
She probably would.
And by the way, this is my problem. It kind of circles back to the Kanye thing, though.
That's what I was about.
Everybody has problems. When you make the decision to never try to make it better, like, you know how many bad experiences Nicki has had with people over in this industry over the years? It's crazy. Yeah. I just went silent 5 years ago. I just was like, I'm not ever going to do this anymore. It doesn't behoove me. So I don't want to be the guy who's still hanging on to this one moment from 2012. Like, I already hear about it enough. Yeah. But I've been sitting here waiting, just like, oh, we'll see how it plays out. Because your experience is not unique.
Nicki's like Kanye if Kanye was much sharper and and less and had more social intelligence.
Nope. Yeah.
Right?
Ooh, Kanye like, doesn't.
Yeah, he's too crazy.
Right. He's
Kanye's
he doesn't have
crazy
emotional
different.
Intelligence. She does, and she's really sharp. And
wait, do you think that's emotional intelligence?
I don't know if it's emotional, but or
it's, she's able to express herself.
She's much more of a manipulator too than Kanye. Kanye's just like blah.
No, yeah. But yeah, basically what you're saying is if I read what I think you're saying, it's that Nicki is actually worse in the sense that it's more thoughtful. She's aware of it. And she's just does it.
Listen to her in that conversation. I just listened to it.
Oh,
I mean, she's playing on words.
Oh,
she's really working. And that's why she gets so exasperated is because she knows.
I can't even say anything.
It's like when you had the interview with 50, right? Where like you were out sort of gunned by 50 because he's.
Yeah. Like every word I said, he would like say something back. And I'm like, well, I didn't mean it that way. And then it's like, all right, let me go to the next thing. And he's like, ah, but you said this. And I'm like. Okay, I didn't know we were competing in this conversation. You know what I mean? That's like what she was doing to Latto. And Latto was just like, so Cipha, what was the feeling you had when you saw the Latto audio came out?
That's your brother put it in a good way. Like she does like, you know, like fighting with Nicki is like fighting with a girlfriend. You know what I mean? Like she takes certain pieces and twist because even like, because she says it like she mirrors her like she must have watched a masterclass or something because Latto says you know like something about other platforms you know and she goes what other platforms what do your research
oh I
and
love like, your research
and you're like do my research on what are you telling me to do what didn't I do research on
right
but it's like it suns you and it takes you off your fucking what's the term like when you're not on your heels or whatever you know what I mean like
it makes you do you mean she makes you uncomfortable
yeah and it's like it puts you on a defensive of something you didn't even think was something wrong that you said so you like start questioning yourself and when you're thinking
what
about
did
it,
I say
she slaps you with another one but she's like no do your research apparently you don't do your and you're like no this is not, has nothing to do with research I'm telling you
It's sort
there's
of
a lot of platforms where people have blown up lately that weren't around 10 years ago when you blew up.
Right. What were you saying there?
Oh, it's sort of the way people are online all the time, particularly somebody who you and I speak a lot about, right? Where it's always, they always got to tell you in some way that they have more information than you do.
Right.
If there's always a put down. But the thing with Latto is like, I got the sense that she was like, yeah. I'm not doing this. I know that I'm right, and you're playing this game with me, and you're gonna make me feel stupid.
And that's why I'm recording it. I'm gonna record this, and that's why
engage. And then at the end, Nicki's all like, "It didn't sound like she was about to be like, I'm gonna bury you," and then decided not to say it, and then just ended
I don't remember. I don't. Is that what you heard too, Cipha?
Yeah, she definitely like got off the phone before she said something too much, but she already, everything she says is too much. But in her mind, she was about to say something that was too much.
I just wonder if people are ever going to like acknowledge the elephant in the room, which is that the lack of unity that everyone seems to believe exists among the women in rap all starts at the head. It all comes down from the top, and Nicki's at the top. Like, that is what the whole thing is.
That Kendrick line that he has in that song where he's arguing with that girl who has why R&B girls can't come together, whatever. That's rap too. Like, and then like, but see, now if you say this, we're talking bad about women. You know what I'm saying? That's how it goes nowadays.
No, I think in this case, Cipha, where you have specific personal situations that you can describe. No,
I'm saying yes, I can discuss my two instances personal with Nicki. Yes. But when we start talking about female rappers don't get along and can't come together, now it's like mouth.
No,
but you're saying that it's a particular reason that there's somebody at the top who's intentionally sort of what's the word, like creating like divisiveness so that she always has like the plurality of support.
Can I also add, like, it's very on some level. Come here, Bear. Come here. It's on some level very. There's some connection between the way 50 handled things and the way Nicki handles things. And I say all of this to say.
So you're saying Queens motherfuckers is grimy?
I was about to say, it comes back to this, you weird ass Queens motherfuckers yet again. And now I'm marrying one. But Queens is fucking weird, man. There is a weird.
Every borough has their thing.
Queens has some weird hater shit that can just feel built in some ways. It's very weird. That wasn't Nas's thing, though.
The fucking Fat Joe on Math Hoffa podcast.
Yeah.
Mentions, he's like, yo, y'all Queens motherfuckers always think everybody don't like you. And then because I think that guy Esso's from Queens.
Uh-huh.
And he's like, y'all Queens. He's like, my wife is from Queens. And it's like, yo, I know, man. Y'all Queens motherfuckers always think people don't like you, man. There's something wrong with y'all. Like, he's like, I was like, that's true, man.
No, you know, and Queens is funny.
In Queens, people are smart. And who's Esso?
Math Hoffa's co-host.
Oh.
He's one of
those. What's that skit on De La? He's like, people be talking about SOs, but I don't know if they're talking about SOs or SOBs.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Cipha, you know what I'm talking about or no?
No, I kind of. Say it again.
It's like a interlude where he's like, people be talking about SOs, but I don't know if they're talking about SOs or SOBs, because I guess SOs was also a club.
Wait. When they say is people be talking about SOs.
Yeah, and then like,
you're saying.
No. That's the whole thing. This is I don't know why I went down this road.
That's what you decided to do. That's.
Well, SOs was a club also, yeah.
There you go. That's the whole thing. There's somebody listening to this that'll appreciate this.
Yeah, of course. This is the only place where this would come up.
Like a Balloon Mind State skit.
Is it a Balloon Mind State skit?
Or Stakes is High? I can't remember.
I was very excited yesterday when at the roller skating thing that we did on a Saturday when Cass won.
They played Biddies?
No, they played Saturdays.
That's what I meant.
Yeah, Cass won.
What do you mean that's what you meant?
No, I meant
two different songs.
Say Biddies.
It's two different songs.
It's not the song.
No, Saturdays is what I meant, though.
Doesn't make sense. You know, Juice, Know the Ledge. Yeah, but we're not talking about Juice, Know the Ledge.
No, but that's
why did you say Biddies?
I don't know, because that's another song. It's right next to it on the album.
Yeah, but I just want to explain some basic things about human communication. Like, you have to say the word you mean.
I know. Yo, Ballard was going off on me.
Uh-oh.
Like,
Nick and Ballard, by the way, Cipha, get into fights on Twitter that, like, requires being mended on the phone every 2 weeks.
He blocked me on Twitter.
Still?
I'm still blocked.
Yo, he blocked him. What were you about to say?
What I was about to say is, like, I know, and Peter, you can attest to this, that on text, sometimes I sort of go off the reservation, like, where it doesn't make any sense anymore. And he's like, what are you talking about? He's like, stay on the subject, right? And I was like, fair enough. I do that sometimes. I'll stick with it. But then he started relying that as on as a crutch in everything I said, I would like sort of raise another point. He'd be like, stick to the subject. And I'm like, well, I didn't acknowledge that just so you could use it
to say,
to I can't always say that I can't say anything.
So you're
anymore.
Saying Ballard's like Nicki Minaj
ish.
Wait, so you're still blocked by Ballard?
Yeah.
I love it.
I checked. I just went. Like it says, sad.
Let me know if you want me to squash this beef.
Oh, no, no. Ballard just said to me, I said, what are you doing? He texted me and I said, oh, my brother's here, blah, blah. He said, nice. And he said, I said, what are you doing? He said, Packers now, Chiefs, Bills later. Want to drag Nick to Indian accent for an early dinner. So he's not mad at you, apparently.
No, no. We're not mad at each other.
But you're still
but he blocked. I'm like, it's weird. What if I see him and he's got like some weird block around him?
Yeah. He'd want to, he wants you blocked in real life. So Cipha, anyways, I'm glad we worked through some of these feelings. We didn't get anywhere, but I'm glad we talked about it. I clearly still have resentments around it too, though. It's only happened in recent years. Like at first, I think I was so geeked off the validation and like endorphin hits of sitting with Nicki Minaj, who was so big at that time. Like the fact that I sat with her for an hour.
Well, and then she like that. Well, she gave you that much.
I got that much attention. It was that big a deal.
Yo, what was that hat she was wearing though?
Yeah, her hat.
I was just about to say, wasn't she wearing like a flight attendant hat or something?
It was a fucking weird hat. Although, and there's another piece to it though. It's not only that. It's that there was a period then that lasted of a couple of years, two or three, maybe more years, where I was on text with Nicki and we would chat in a nice way.
And
for
she
a while.
Would just call you.
And she would randomly call me, right?
Yeah, like ask you your opinion about things.
Yeah,
like,
she would call me and be like, she would call and ask me random shit. So like
I remember you told me a story that one morning she called you early and you were like that she said, like, I know you're wondering why is this bitch calling me at 8 o'clock in the morning? Like
Nick remembers so many stories about me that I don't remember. I forgot that.
I need a Nick.
A brother?
Too late. If you have interesting stories you could tell me, maybe I'll remember them.
Now listen, if I ask Nick to remember something that like I need to know that day, forget it. Absolutely in and out.
I hope Jenny never listens to the Patreon edition.
Don't worry. I feel safe that she won't listen to this.
She'll be like, yo, that's the stuff you remember?
Well, yeah.
You didn't remember Jess's prescription.
That's a really good line. But so I think because of that though, because we then formed a friendship. To some degree, I wasn't resentful of the fact that she sunned me and made me look like such an ass. And now that I'm not in any way in communication with her at all, and a couple times a year, people just send me the little clip, the 8-second clip of her going, I never found you smart. I never found you funny. I never found you blah, blah, blah. And people are like, yeah, Rosenberg, suck a dick. As a result of that.
I mean, you put that out, though. So.
The interview.
Yeah. You did that to yourself.
I know. By the way, we should have done what normal people would have done and cut the interview so I didn't look like a total asshole.
Yo, it's actually kind of crazy.
We just let her totally set the tone.
That was probably a whole deal, though, right?
No. That's why Ebro was there, too. There was some funny shit going on because she wanted to have Ebro there and Ebro ran. Like, it should have been me and her alone. It should not have been someone else's there. But, you know.
Yo, maybe Nicki is Ray from North Carolina.
You know what? It's a really unlikely.
Is that a sports thing? What just happened?
It's from the K show. You've seen me post a clip before, Cipha, the guy who called the show, called the K show and said how much he hated me.
Yeah.
I hate.
But then here now go back to my original point. Stick to the point.
Sorry. Okay,
I don't wanna sit here and badmouth black women. I don't want to be that guy.
You're bad-mouthing Nicki Minaj.
I know, but it's like she I feel she needs help.
But by the way,
help, I'm not talking about like help doesn't always mean like this big grandiose spectacle of like mental institute. Like sometimes you just need a friend, you know what I mean?
You guys think that horn that's used in Chun-Li is the same horn from Curious Walk Like a Duck?
I don't think it's
Yeah, but I think people would probably tell you, Cipha, you start getting into like You start sounding a little like mansplainy and preachy when you start telling people they need help. I do it too. I'm not knocking you for it. I'm just saying that's what people will say when you say someone needs help.
Those are often people who haven't gotten help. I get it.
Correct.
I get it all the time.
Exactly.
If you've never sat down with a therapist, when people badmouth therapy, I'm like, oh my God, they are so like, they have no idea what they're talking about. It's really, it's sad to be on the other side of it and have so much different perspective and then wish everyone would see that. It doesn't help me if you get help. It helps you.
I know. That's what help is.
Nah, but I can make the same argument about religion for some people, right? Like that if people are living their lives in ways that are good and productive and they're happy and they have that, then, you know, who is anybody else to bash it? It's like, but the funny thing with Kanye, it's like he's jamming all this religion down everybody's throat. And it's like, has he found God? Because it doesn't seem like it to me.
Well, it's sort of like Kanye with religion. Well, because that's the difference between religion and therapy, though.
Well, oh, like
you couldn't get obsessed with therapy and act the way Kanye's acting. Like that's not what, like you'd have to have, your therapist was like a crack fiend. It wasn't like a real therapist, because you can get involved in religion and swear that you've seen the light, but you haven't seen anything. You're not doing anything right. You're literally just reading in church, right? So I feel like you're sitting there, you're doing the part. You're like, I'm religious. I go to church. I care.
True.
Kanye's saying all these things about religion. He doesn't know anything about religion. Like Kanye yesterday. So I've had any, you haven't seen any clips yet, have you?
Of Dream Champs?
Yeah. You saw the George Floyd?
Yeah.
Like they're just missing, and then Nori tried. Nori was just a little too drunk.
What did he say about George? What did
he say? He said George Floyd. He was like, the guy didn't even have his knee on his neck. His knee wasn't even on his neck. And I thought Nori's response was actually really good. I wish he could have followed it up with more detail. But Nori was like, but that's not the point. Like, no, not only is what he's saying fucking crazy, like what? I don't know how you, Candace Owens told you that. Okay, I get it.
What does it even matter?
But how does that matter, bro? Like you're missing the whole, or wait, so you're saying black people aren't murdered by the police then? Is that what you're saying?
What's the point? Number one, what's the point? Number two, what's the point about the specific thing that you're saying? Like it's
he flipped it and said, yeah, because you know what George Floyd looked like? Virgil. Now let's talk about what Louis Vuitton did to Virgil. And by the way, like,
what is that?
What?
Yes. And by the way, can we just put this out?
What the fuck does that mean?
Yo, Virgil died of cancer, bro. I don't think there's no.
Yo, Virgil's like, what are you doing?
Dude, and by the way.
Keep my name out of your mouth.
No, how about this? And you're hating. Kanye, you're mad. Virgil made it. You guys were together. You became Kanye West, crazy music icon, but still wanted to run fashion. Virgil pursued fashion and became the real Louis Vuitton Don. You're fucking tight about it.
Wasn't there a quote where Kanye said they wanted him to do that job before Virgil or something? Yes. Did you see that quote?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, and now you're trying to flip it into something where Louis Vuitton was responsible for Virgil's death when it seems clear. And listen, I'm no knowledgeable person on Louis Vuitton. Seems pretty clear they loved and honored him when he died. Like, it seems like
this is not even worth it. It's not even worth
insane.
Indulging in.
I know. But it's really the fact that he flipped the George Floyd into that. I was like, oh boy. I wonder if he did any. I didn't see any clips about any real substantial. I saw a little White Lives Matter shirt clip, which made no sense.
It's just about burning as much shit down as you possibly can.
Is that what you think the plan is?
But to what?
I don't know.
Goal? What's the end game?
Like, I don't know if he's mad at Louis Vuitton. Try to burn Louis Vuitton down. If he's mad at Virgil, try to burn Virgil down. You know, just burn his family down. Like,
why? But to Cipha's point, what's the end game in ripping down everything out there?
Well, when you feel like you're losing, I mean, I don't. I'm not comparing Hitler and Kanye West.
It would be an appropriate thing to do at this point.
But you know, at the end, Hitler was like, all right, we're losing. Destroy the whole country. Burn down all the farms. bomb all the factories, destroy the entire thing. So when they walk in, there's nothing. They don't have anything.
But there's no, but this isn't a world war and no one's going to walk in to see what Kanye's burned
and
down.
And that's also, but it's psycho no matter what.
In his mind, it is a world war.
And if you think that you're like, you're the all powerful one, right? And you have all of these assets and you're just like, well, I'll just destroy everything and everybody's going to be the worse off. I don't know. I'm making
what
shit
I'm
up.
Resent-
I don't know
what I'm talking about. I'm resentful about with regard to it is that it takes up bandwidth on all of us. Like, and honestly, all three of us having this conversation, Cipha, who generally doesn't care about anything, is still at least aware of this, all the Kanye shit. Like, it makes it to you. You can't avoid it.
Yeah.
Nick, you have plenty of other things going on in your life to think about, and yet you also waste energy on Kanye. I'm forced and do it by choice. I have to do it on the radio, but I also take it home with me and talk about it. It's like, I'm fucking annoyed that we even waste our time talking about a dude who, the thing that hit me so hard this week is it was so obvious. I don't know if you caught it, Cipha and Nick, but he said, yo, they're trying to call me anti-Semite.
I like that.
Black people are Semite, so I can't be an anti-Semite. I'm like, bro, that's the most basic black Israelite shit. It's been said 1,000 times. You just heard that now? You literally just ran with that. Now, every time I've beefed with someone over anti-Semitism, I've gotten that line. He heard it last week and was like, oh my God, you're right. I am Semite. I can't be anti-Semite. I'm like, how did you think that was profound? That shit is so basic. But he doesn't read. He doesn't read. He doesn't educate himself. He doesn't know anything. He just listens to words people say and regurgitates it. And then here we are having to fucking deal with it.
Well, because I love Kanye though.
See, do you actually still have that feeling? I don't even have that feeling anymore. I love his music, but the feeling of like, oh, I love Kanye, that has left me.
If you saw him tomorrow, would you take a picture with him?
No.
You would not take a picture with Kanye West.
No, definitely not. Not
what if he sends you a verse for your album?
I'm not putting out an album.
I'd be surprised.
I'd be like, why am I doing an album?
Would I try to find a way to make it work?
Oh, this is such a
bullshit answer. No. Well, no, this is the real answer. I'm going to give you total truth. You said, would I take a picture with Kanye?
Yeah.
No. Would I talk to him and want to be like, dude, what's going on? Would I be nice to him and try to get a real answer? Yes. I would not just be like, fuck you, Kanye, and walk away. I would definitely be like, bro, can we talk? Can I please talk to you for a minute? Would I do that? Yes. I don't like hate him to the point that I don't care and want him to be better. But I also can't relate to what Nick said, being like, yeah, but I love Kanye. I don't feel anymore.
Kanye gives you a song with Kanye West.
Keep going.
A lost J Dilla beat. With Kanye West and fucking
Big Pun.
Oof, that's good.
And who? And Pun?
Yeah.
And Pun. What do you do?
I couldn't use it unless I had a conversation with him first and I somehow got to a place that I felt comfortable. But
really?
Then I wouldn't be able to put it out unless he publicly renounced everything he said. Yo, bro, I don't think you could do an interview with him. What Spring Hill did this week by pulling their interview.
That's
with
what
him,
you were about was to tell. Yeah, so Spring Hill is
Spring
the
Hill's
shop.
LeBron's company, and they run the shop. Kanye
what
did
is the shop on? Well, I always see clips from that. How do I watch that show?
It used to be on HBO. It's now on YouTube.
It's just on YouTube.
That was smart what they did, though. That's the way to handle it.
So Kanye does the shop.
Who else was on it?
Dude, don't
Maverick Carter, right?
He's on every week.
Oh. Okay, I never
That dude PR who's on every week. I don't remember. No, the other guests were not like, I don't remember being like finding them uber notable. Like they make sense.
Paula Poundstone.
Separate. By the way, separate point. That is to me what the booking is often like on the shop. I don't understand why they have the people they have sitting there. I'm like, this. Who brought these people?
It's Hollywood. It's Hollywood.
But I know the dude. The dude who does a lot of their booking, like, no shit. And yet,
that's Hollywood. That's you run into people. They're like, oh, I want to do on the show.
You know what? And the booker, who is a smart dude, who I know, he probably has to deal with them being like, you know who would be good is so and so, and he's probably like, they wouldn't be good. But
no, you're okay. In LA, you run into people all the time. You're at the same restaurant, same club.
Oh, we should do this.
Yeah, do the show. Do come. Let me come do the show.
So I don't remember who it was to answer your question, but they decided to pull the episode and they put out a statement basically being like, we're not gonna put out Kanye's hate speech. And he echoed sentiments that we don't, you know, appreciate or believe here. And honestly,
which is also Hollywood.
What do you mean?
That response is also very Hollywood. Protective. That's why Kanye goes to his friend Nori, because Nori allows wild shit.
But here's the funny part. Honestly, Spring Hill did him a favor.
Right.
They did him a favor. He won't realize it now. He probably feels like, fuck them. They want to quiet my voice.
The Jews.
Bro, they saved you. He was on the verge. That would have been his next major like Jew meltdown. They did him a favor.
And they said it was?
I think that was implied, I feel like, in the statement, was that it was anti-Semitic.
Did you hear that on Tucker Carlson? They had to cut everything.
And a bunch of shit came out. You saw some of it came out.
No, right? I just read that they had to like clip it so much.
Oh, they
between the to get out of the
someone,
most crazy.
Someone leaked a few of the clips of extra anti-Semitic dumb nonsense. It's so
funny. What did Tucker Carlson, because like I feel like he'd be like, come on.
What do you mean?
Is Rupert Murdoch Jewish?
He doesn't care. Is Rupert Murdoch Jewish?
No.
It's a lot. I don't know what I'm ready to do. I can't look away from it. I'm not gonna sit here and lie. It's not like I'm not paying attention.
So Kanye says, fuck it, take this song.
You just want to keep
you
going.
Don't do it. That's crazy.
I wouldn't do it.
I thought he was about to have a big face turn.
What? When did you think that was going to happen?
Because I saw that he had lunch with Michael Cohen.
Oh, that I remember when you fantasy booked that entire thing. So, if you remember when there was pictures came out that he had lunch with Michael Cohen, the lawyer?
No.
The Trump, and he hates Trump, and I thought
Cohen
maybe
flipped on Trump.
Yeah, and I thought maybe he was trying to get Kanye to flip on Trump.
He was trying.
He might have been trying that, because I think that Kanye has some information about election manipulation. But
instead, Kanye flipped on Kushner. And by the way, what a weird answer last week when talking about Trump being great. Yeah, he dissed Jared Kushner too, and Kushner's brother. It was in the Tucker Carlson thing. He said that like they only care about money and they don't care about blah blah blah. And then when they asked about why he loves Trump, and his answer was he made Ivanka. Like, so, bro, that's a weird answer, bro.
There's also crazy. Did you hear that there's like Roger Stone calling Ivanka an abortionist bitch on the phone?
I heard that too. That was crazy. We live in end of days, guys.
I saw Bun B. You saw Bun B's Instagram where he's like, why are we giving these people attention?
Yeah.
Like, that's how I live my life. Like, Kanye clip comes up on my Instagram or TikTok. I might watch it. I might not. But that's it. That's it to me. Like, why is there so much fucking attention given to this shit?
We're celebrity obsessed. We really are.
I'm not. Not in that way.
No, you're only celebrity obsessed in the sense that last week a celebrity sent you a text message and said, Denver, bitch, and you got up and ran.
My friend sent me a text message.
For a second, I thought you were going to say that Bun B said, like, I was like, of all the people who would never go on a rant about somebody.
Oh, you thought Bun was going to?
Yeah. I was like, how are you connecting Bun here?
Yeah, no, Bun makes sense. And
I know Bun B because I'm Mr. Name Dropper.
That's right. Name Dropper. All right, Billy June, let's switch gears for a second. Billy June, it sounds like.
Stick to the subject.
It seems like since the last time we talked, Billy June, you actually made some improvements to your life. Is this true?
I'm working on it.
I figured I want Billy. One second. I feel it. I just figured I want it. It just hit me. I can't believe it. It just hit me.
Okay.
We're doing a daily talk show. We're doing a morning show.
Yeah.
But in weekly podcast form.
Correct.
It doesn't make sense.
What we're doing doesn't make sense.
We're doing a daily show where we talk about stuff, but we put it in the form of a podcast that's supposed to be more, I guess, themed or specific.
So what are you saying? Keep going.
We're fucking up. We're doing.
What? We're hustling backwards.
We're doing the wrong show in the wrong format.
So then,
I think that's the charm, sort of.
Well, then hold on.
Yes, but it's why it's not big, because it's not. It's a daily show that we don't.
Okay,
do daily.
Okay. How about this? Fuck with me for a second.
Yeah.
What if we somehow did it every day for like 20 minutes? But it was every day. Everyone woke up, got 20 minutes of one up every day.
That's.
Could that be something?
That sounds like something.
Like, could that be? Because I do agree, it does feel like a daily morning show. I've been thinking that.
It's like a daily show, but it's like to what we like and through our perspective. Like, we couldn't have this in-depth conversation on Hot 97 because we were, you know, we were tied to advertisements and time frames and all that. But really get breaking shit down in a loose daily friendly way that you talk shit with your friends.
How about this? Let's keep going.
Yeah.
What if we made the podcast 5 days a week for 20 minutes, right? 20 minutes each day we have to make.
I think we would still have to have a podcast version.
But that's the Patreon.
Ding, ding, ding.
The Patreon is you get the hour one. That's Patreon. The free is every day you're going to wake up and have a 20-minute episode of the show.
Yo, but
it'll be there for your commute.
Do you delete it after a day?
Why?
Well, because why would people pay for it if they could just listen to all five in a row?
No.
It's a different podcast.
It's a different one. Like, you know, 5 days a week, you get 20. But then if you want the weekend edition, Cipha, you know how when you get subscribe to a newspaper, it's like the Sunday Times. Don't give you the paper every day for a quarter. Yeah. But you want the paper on Sunday?
You want the magazine.
You got to pay $2.50.
Okay. Let's talk.
Should we talk about this?
Let's talk about it.
Billy June, by the way, that was a really good contribution about your life. Thank you for sharing.
Sorry, just for some reason, it literally just smacked me in the face. All right, go ahead. Billy June.
Hi.
So you've made some. So you've made some improvements.
I'm working on it. Yeah.
Go ahead. Give a little more. A little more info.
Before I say that, I wrote it in the private chat, but I don't think he saw it. Safe. Instead of Mr.
Look,
name,
here's my laptop. Does it look like I can reach it?
I don't know. No. Okay.
Well, can you say on the podcast what you wanted to say?
You kept saying that you're Mr. Name Dropper now.
Yeah, Mr. Yeah. Name
and
Dropper.
You're talking about how many podcasts you do for clips. You're also Mr. Clip Dropper.
Oh, Clip Dropper. Why did you bring that up right now, Billy?
It's been on my mind, and I had to say it.
You're Mr. Clip Dropper.
Mr. Clip Dropper.
Okay. He's a Clip Dropper. So, Billy?
Zigzag.
Yeah,
Why this music? I was on
T-Pain.
Why show. This music?
Wait, hold on.
Never mind. It just clicked with me. When you
bro, I was on T-Pain show.
Why do you always have those guitars? There's a...
Wait, say it again.
I was on T-Pain show, and he goes, Cipha, you name drop so much. It sounds like I'm listening to a game album.
a game album? Oh, by the way, didn't you see the clip I posted recently?
No.
I posted a clip of you and Mac Miller and Ebro having a conversation.
I didn't see it.
And Mac said something. Mac was name dropping. And I was like, and we made a joke about the game. And he was like, yo, I am the game.
Oh,
like,
really?
Yeah, hold on. I'm about to play for you right now. You didn't see that?
He's a name dropper?
He was name dropping, number one name dropping. It was during the awkward period on the show, Cipha, when you were slowly being usurped of your role. Here we go. Here's the clip. Here we go.
Sorry. So me, there's a dude named Vince Staples, right? And I'm doing a.
And he's yeah.
And he's very sick. And I'm doing a.
Sick as a rapper.
Right.
The way you said that was like matter of fact, not good.
Might not make it through the night.
Yeah, like that's what it sounded like, right?
Sorry, Vince.
All right, no, I'm very sick.
Whatever you came down with, brother, we hit.
He's a dope rapper. Yes.
No. So we're doing a EP together, and I did the beats, and he's doing the raps, and Peter had heard it, and he told me that. He's gonna support it, and it's. And,
I just said I was very impressed with the beats. I told him right when I came in. I said you're gonna be surprised when you hear Max beats.
The people that have reached out, because I'm real self conscious about my beats, because I'm just starting out as a, you know, like getting it out there. You know, but people don't know is that I've had beats on pretty much every single project I did, but just like one, and they weren't all the way there. But now I've been making beats for real, and the people that have reached out and told me that they like really are impressed by my production. It's crazy. Like, Alchemist freaks out over my beats, like, all the time, which is sick. Like, you know, sorry, that's name dropping.
Name dropping again. But it's dope. No, it's cool.
Did you watch
Nas,
drop those names. You're, like, Pharrell. Worst in the game right now, man.
Right.
Your game song.
I'm a walking game song. Shout out to A. Shout out to the game.
Because
we were in France and we were partying.
Yo, that was the best.
That's very funny.
You made the joke. You said you're like a game song. And he said, yeah, but shout out to the game because I was with him in France. He really was. A legit name drop.
Yo, but the game name drops, some of his name drops
aren't even nice.
Well, and they're not even like, I know the person. It's just a reference to a person.
Correct. It's not always a drop. It's a thing.
Well, he's King Name Dropper, and I'm just Mr. Name Dropper.
No, you're Mr. Name Dropper. All right, back to Mr. Cleaning Out My Closet.
Mr. Name Dropper.
Oh, Billy June, how much have you gotten rid of this week?
A lot of garbage and clothing that doesn't fit me.
Okay.
And a lot of recycling. And I dropped off 100 pounds of clothing at the laundromat.
100 pounds of clothes at the laundromat?
What did that cost?
$95.
That's not even bad. That's a pretty good deal. So,
I made a deal with my roommate. I said, I'll go with you for one drink if you help me carry half the bags to the laundromat.
But now, real quick.
You carry them? You don't have a little cart?
It was fine. Did you see the picture I sent you? It was literally
Billy. Just answer the question.
No, I don't have a cart.
Okay, you need to get a cart.
Now, real quick, Billy, do you need the 100 pounds of clothes that you brought there?
There's more. I'm figuring that out, but also there's more clothes here that I'm not, that I didn't get.
You should play thrift shop right now.
Oh, yo, thank you, Nick. You know what? Okay. I'm slipping.
All right, what's up with all these clothes you have? How much? How much? Let me.
It's a lot of stuff. No, you can't see anything. I'm all plugged in.
Are you on your laptop?
Yeah.
What do you mean you're all plugged in? What does that mean?
I have a setup right now.
So you can't move your laptop.
I can't move my laptop at all right now.
Take your phone and click on the link on your phone.
It looks like a mess.
Click on.
You're saying if we see what your room actually looks like.
It's a work in progress. That's why I'm saying it's not officially done yet.
Oh, cool. Go to the link of what we're using on your phone and click on it so that your phone can be a mobile camera.
Oh, that's a good idea, Seth.
This is the setup.
There's your computer.
Where's the clothes?
Some of it's there.
And is that your bed in the corner?
That's your bed? I put my bed back.
What is that on the floor there? Is that a mattress?
That's where you do hair.
Don't turn it on to you ever again. This is only for showing your room.
I'm literally want to see your face reorganizing and cleaning.
If we want to see your face, if we want to see your face, you go back to your computer setup. You never put this phone on you. So now go to the left.
Left.
Left. Left. Down. Down. Now what is that on the ground there? Is that your mattress?
What is the yellow thing?
Banana.
That's an egg crate.
Oh, that's what I thought of.
And what's the egg crate for?
My bed.
Oh, to lay on top of the bed. Okay.
What is it for?
Down there is like all clothing I want to sell.
Sell?
Yeah, it's all in bags.
What kind of clothing are you selling?
All old shit that I haven't thrown out.
Like what? Like what is it? Some like Supreme or Bape? Like
no.
What brands is it?
No, it's like promo items, right? What's the clothing piled on, Billy June? Is it piled on something? Or is that straight from the ground?
No, that's a couch.
Oh, it's a couch. You can't see the couch. There's no couch visible. You know that, right?
Where's all the laundry?
There you go. Okay, I see it. I take it back. I see couch. Okay.
It's a couch.
Where's the laundry you did?
It's still the laundromat.
Okay, so this is
I'm not
all
picking
stuff
it up until I need it.
I don't know. They're not storage. It units, put it back
properly.
It's not Manhattan mini storage. You got to get it.
Walk away.
So.
It's not about that. They don't care where you're located. They just don't want to have your stuff.
No, I said I would pick it up. I will.
Why did you tell us the distance? I don't understand.
Okay, so, anyways.
What's happening with this pile of clothes here on your couch?
That's all nice clothing that I have to put away.
So why don't you put it away?
Yeah, like that's this.
I haven't yet.
No. I know what you haven't yet. My question is, why haven't you?
Work in progress.
No. That's not an answer to the question.
I've been working. I did a lot Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and now I have to get back into it.
Okay. So, real quick, without
that's all shit I have to sell too. That's an old Kiss jacket, and there's like 10 bins.
That's all stuff to get rid of?
I don't know yet. Here, I'll show you.
You guys should just go to his house and do it.
We thought about that. It's been discussed.
That's just my like sister's that I'm going to sell for her.
Okay.
But Billy, you're not organized to sell stuff. What is all this?
That's books.
But just give it away. Just bring it to Goodwill.
Simpsons feel stuff.
What is it?
Itchy and scratchy Simpsons thing? You'll feel so much better if you just get rid of it.
I don't like getting rid of things either.
Neither do I, but you can't live like this.
Yeah. And then I have 45 of my grandpa's paintings, if anybody wants a painting.
45?
Let's see some of your grandpa's paintings.
Real quick, why did your parents insist that you take all of your grandfather's paintings?
Throwing them out. I took them. They didn't know.
Let's see some of the paintings.
I hope one of them is like one of the dogs is looking this way and the other
one of the dogs looking the other way and he's going, what are you looking at?
That's one.
Let's see some of the paintings.
I said that's one.
The ones on the ground.
No, yeah, let's see some of the ones on the ground. Maybe there's one.
Fuck.
You can't even get to it. You're going to hurt yourself.
No, I'm good.
Hold on.
That's nice.
That's actually pretty. He's pretty good. This is the same grandfather who was in the music business?
No, my dad's father.
He was an artist?
Yeah.
What is that?
It's a woman dancing.
Hey, Billie Jean, do me a favor. Can you have your hands shake so much that we vomit when we watch you?
I'm standing on a mattress.
The name of your album.
Standing on. Yo, he's good, man.
Yeah, he's pretty good really painting. Cool.
So, do you want to? The funny.
You know what you should do, Billie Jean? You know what would be nice, honestly? You should give those to people as gifts.
I've been thinking about it.
Each person can have one, and your grandfather's art can live on in people's homes.
Well, here's the funny part about it. So, my grandpa used to. They lived in like a retirement area.
Okay.
And at the public library in the retirement area, they would let you rent out paintings. So he would rent the paintings and repaint them himself and then return them. So those are all things that he copied.
Oh, so the ripoffs, nothing's original.
Yeah. Some of them are, there's one of me.
Okay.
I don't know where it is.
All right. Well, Billie Jean, I'm going to help you out then. The ones that are just ripoffs, just fucking get rid of them. Your parents
I like them all.
45? Pick two.
Or 44.
Yo, Billy, pick two. Keep the one of you. Pick a couple other ones you like. If they're literally, they were things he just copied and did for fun.
But I like them.
Right.
I like
you
them.
You like them enough to have 40?
I want to give them away. I just haven't figured. I need to do like a garage sale or something.
Yeah, Jenny told me to only keep 50 t-shirts. I threw away some good t-shirts.
How long ago?
10 years ago. I was like, I'll never want two Lloyd Banks Hunger for More t-shirts.
And now you wish you had that.
Yeah, of course I do.
But by the way, his stuff is not a Lloyd Banks Hunger for More t-shirt. It's a copycat painting that his grandpa.
I have a lot of shirts like that too.
I know you do.
But I don't think the shirts, I wouldn't throw those out. I mean,
if
you fold all your clothes and put all your paintings in one section in a pile or like a row,
fuck it. I'm gonna rip my laptop up.
That sounded extreme.
What? Oh, we lost. I thought he meant he was like gonna rip it because he was so angry.
That's what I thought.
No,
too.
I think he meant he was gonna like pull it out of the wire, and he did because it says device not connected. So either, Cyph, we drove him to the point of smashing his computer at this moment.
Oh. I disconnected it.
Okay.
And I can't get the camera back on.
All right, no worries.
Why did you disconnect it?
I was said, fuck it, and I was going to take my laptop and show you. Because I do
but
fold things.
We already
things.
Saw what you're
No,
phone.
But fuck it. No, because I do fold things.
But what was wrong with showing us that with your phone? Here's what I'm getting at, Billy.
Here we go.
It's not about your clothes, your floor, your garbage, your stuff. It's about you.
He's like, oh, your mom.
It's about you. Why like. You don't? You can't answer simple questions, and you make these crazy rush decisions. Like, what was wrong? And I want you to really think about it and not think that I'm harassing you or bullying you.
Hold it. I can't say hold on. Hold on.
You're not even listening as I'm telling you how to listen.
I'm listening.
I don't want to see your folded clothes. I want you to listen to me. I want you to answer this question. Why did you have to rip your laptop out when you were already using your phone and using your phone was fine?
Matter of fact,
using your phone was better.
What was the answer, Billy?
Because I closed it.
Closed what?
The phone.
It's not a flip phone. What do you mean you closed? You closed the app?
I closed the app.
So why you could just relaunch it?
I know. I got frustrated.
But all right. That's my point. You always get these moments of frustration, and they lead you to make bad decisions.
You get a case of the fuck-its, Billy June, and the fuck-its are not good. You got to avoid the fuck-its.
I actually had my first therapist, Dr. Rydberg.
Yeah.
That was his motto. He was like, sometimes you just got to say fuck it.
Yeah. By the way, and for some people, I would say that's a useful piece of advice. For other people, everything's fuck it. And you don't want to say fuck it to everything. Billy June, listen, I'm glad you started the process. I saw Billy June yesterday. He looked good. He looked like he had his shit together a little bit. Seemed he was upbeat. And like, you know, I could just tell that he felt like you'd accomplished things this week. So I know we're not able to see it all, but I do have faith that you've taken steps. You took the laundry to the laundromat.
I just have to pick it up.
But before you pick it up,
I want to get the room together before I pick it up. Because I don't like,
when we finish recording, do you have hangers?
Yeah.
You could just hang.
I have a closet. I showed you. Oh, it's a fake closet. It's a rack.
So you can literally start hanging that stuff the second we get off the phone.
No.
Why not?
What stuff?
The stuff on your couch.
Oh, yeah, I could.
Can't do that, Nick. Every time you get your headphones off.
Oh, it makes noise.
Yes, it's constantly making noise right now.
I could do that. You're right.
Yeah, what's hard about that?
I don't know. It's not hard.
No, but all right. Well,
really try to dig deep, Billy, and try to answer.
I can do it. How about you do it?
So let's do it.
Okay.
Cyph, ask Billy an actionable item, and let's see if he can give you an answer you want.
Well, like, what do you mean? Like, what?
What's something you can ask?
But this is what I'm trying to say. I'm joking around for the show purposes, but on a personal level, Billy, you get these moments of frustration, and I think it leads you to make quick, bad decisions. And I think you got to step back and breathe. And every time I try to give you some advice, you blow me off.
That's not true.
Oh. Oh, I believe it is.
I don't know if you'd view it as blowing it off, Billy. I think you'd view it as like.
I took everything you said the last time we all recorded in the same room to heart.
No.
Yeah. I mean, as somebody who blows off advice.
Yeah.
No.
That is blowing off advice.
Oh.
Because you can take it to heart.
Yeah, but that doesn't like mean shit.
You do action on it.
But why
I started acting on it.
But why do you associate, I guess here's what I'm saying. Why do you associate two people who clearly care about you and have included you in their thing that they've been doing?
I don't care about Billy June?
Three people who care about you and have been including you in all these things for over a decade. Why feel like you shouldn't? I hear why no one likes to have their flaws pointed out, but we're like, our relationship is like older brothers. Cipha and I are much older than you.
I know that.
So like, there's nothing to feel like shit about.
I think that was just a bad day in general, and I took it very differently.
That's unfortunate.
I was having a bad day in general.
Well, for
and
future,
then I took it way more personally than I probably should have.
For future reference, if that's happening, you know you can say, hey, guys, I don't want to make this shit about me today.
Maybe you should have a safe word on the podcast. Cacao.
It was just one day. Everything else has been fine.
All right. Well, next time it happens, say, hey, guys, you know what? Not today. I'm good. That's okay. You're allowed to do that. But Sipe's also right. Go fucking hang those clothes, man. You're close. You're making progress, but you got to finish the progress.
I will.
That is
or it's nothing. If you don't finish cleaning the room, You're this never going to get of time. The feeling. You're, yeah, you're never.
The stuff you did so far will just be a waste of time.
Yo, and Billy,
it seems like time to you is an issue.
Yeah. It's I have the same problem. And then you start it, and then you like get 75% of the way done, and then you're like, I'm going to take a break.
Yep, that's my life.
And then then you're like, I'm so close, I could take a break now, and then you don't finish, and then you're basically back at 0% again.
You can't take a break.
I just got home from a trip, Billy. The moment I walked into my house, I took all my dirty clothes out of the suitcase and I threw them in the wash. Did a load of wash, dried some stuff, hung up the stuff that needs to get air dried. And I'm about to go upstairs and unpack. I have to go away again on Thursday. I could literally just leave all the same clothes in my suitcase, rock out.
That's disgusting.
I put them all away and then I repack on Wednesday.
Why? And okay, why do you do that, Cipha?
Because I like order. I like my sneaker room where my suitcase is right now. I don't like to see a suitcase laying on the floor all 3-4 days.
It brings you peace to have
You peace to have a nice Billy. What if we get two, like, not just cleaning women, but like women who are like, not even, that might not even be women. I apologize if I'm doing gender roles. Cleaning persons that are cleaners, but also help organize.
Someone else offered me that too.
Yeah. So why? What if we did that? Was my question, and then you have to answer it, not offer some left field shit that someone else also offered you. That
I'm not interested.
Why?
Why he's a hoarder? Because he's a hoarder.
Because I'm a hoarder. Yeah. Kelly tried to help me. We got into a fight. She got a few things thrown out. My now ex-girlfriend tried to help me. She bought me some organizational shit. She helped
me.
Where's
the organization shit?
It's in the closet. The fake closet. And
not even being used.
No, it's being used.
Oh.
And we threw a lot of stuff out, but
from what I know of hoarding, it's not about the stuff. There's some other stuff going on with you. And you not being able to let go of these things is a clear indication that there's some things going on. You have some trauma you have to deal with.
That the whole thing, the cleaning thing is a representation of something else. But I feel like to take the steps in the other thing, you have to take the steps with the cleaning. Like you have to, it kind of goes together.
I think on the cleaning.
The problem though is, Cipha, like
you
operate in a particular way. You can't understand the way Billy June operates, right?
That
Billy
is true.
June can't understand the way you operate. Like I remember like my mother-in-law one day, somehow the subject came up of people losing their vaccine cards. And she was like, I don't understand how anybody can lose their vaccine card.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you don't understand how anybody could lose your vaccine card because you never would lose your vaccine card.
Okay, so the people who lose their vaccine cards.
Who lose their vaccine cards and they're not bad people or stupid people or anything, but she can't sort of understand that mentality of losing your vaccine card.
But here's the difference. The people that lose their vaccine cards, they can't understand how some people don't lose their vaccine cards. No, they know how people cannot lose them.
By not being in a disorganized.
Yeah, put them in a certain place.
I just walked in. Put them in a certain place. Are we institutionalizing Billy June?
And I swear to God, I can't make this up. I'm very disorganized and I'm messy, but I know where everything is. And then when I clean, and I actually clean and like put everything away, I can't find anything, and then I throw everything up in the air, and it looks like a fucking tornado hit it, and I'm back to square one. I know where everything is, and I have a very good memory.
No, you don't. You don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
You know where some things are.
Do you know where your vaccine card is?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Hey, listen, I think we've made some progress here today. I got to go. all right, guys, we appreciate you, our patrons. We thought we were giving you 20 minutes. We gave you like an hour, so we hope you like it. All right? Thank you for being our loyal listeners. Nick, thank you for contributing.
I hope I contributed. I hope it wasn't worse than usual.
No, I don't think it was. Do you think
I'm fishing for
You think Nick made the podcast worse?
Yeah.
All right. Later, everyone.
Bye.